So today we are going to start with the basketball injuries. So first injury is knee injury. So mechanism of the injury and the specific anatomy. A knee injury is when one of four ligaments in the knee is stretched out or the torn or the torn out. The four basic ligaments are the four main important knee ligaments are the ACL, anterior cruciate ligament, PCL, posterior cruciate ligament, and the MCL, medial collateral ligament, and the LCL, that is lateral collateral ligament. These ligaments keep the patella and the all leg bones in place while walking or running. When of the above four ligament is injured, the knee joint can become very loose and the unstable. In basketball, the ACL and the PCL are the most common ligament tear with the ACL is being more prevalent. The ACL and the PCLs form an X shape with the knee and control the back and the forth motion. The ACL runs diagonally in the middle of the knee, and the ACL tears occurs if the basketball player lands incorrectly, form a jump, changes the direction or to stop suddenly. The PCL is located at the back of the knee, and the PCL tear out if there is direct blow on the knee and if the patella is twisted out. So this is the diagram which is showing ACL and the PCL ligament. Now, how to assess a knee injury? Loss of range of motion. If there is something happen in the knee, first how to assess is the first sign you can see is or you can assess is loss of range of motions, swelling, discolorations, pain on palpations around the area of ligament, pain when walking and the running. Treating and taping a knee injury. So how to treat and how to tape a knee injury? It depends on the degree of strain or degree of torn out of the ligament. For any knee ligament tear, getting a brace is the best option to protect the knee from instability. The uses of crutch to prevent from putting weight on the injured knee would further protect it as well. Taping is usually not the best treatment for the knee ligament tear, as it is not effective in repairing the ligament and require lot of tape, which only lasts a short time before the knee would need to be retaped. However, the most tear can only heal if they are surgically reconstructed to restore the knee stability. Taping is not suggested for the knee sprain. Now, what is the physiology behind the swelling? Swelling is very common in any ligament tear, too, as it increases in the blood flow, and all the blood cells cause vasodilations to create a natural spleen to protect the knee ligament from worsening the conditions. And the increase in blood flow and the cells also start to set up the stage for healing. If the ligament tear is not very serious, much of the pain also comes from the blood flow exerting pressure on the nerves. Now, pain and the pain management. So the basic treatment for any pain or any injury for the sports player is, the mnemonic is PRICE. P stands for prevent, R stands for rest, I stands for the eyes, C is compression, and E is elevation. So first of all, what we can do is P for prevent, how to prevent the injury. Now next one is the rise, allowing the knee joint to rest and not putting any weight on the leg with the injury would assist with pain. Ice pack would be the best method for a knee injury to reduce swelling and assist with the pain. Next is ankle sprain. So it can happen just because of the sudden inversion of the knee ankle joint or the eversion of the ankle joint. So mechanism of injury is, at an ankle sprain is when one of the ligament in the ankle is stretched out or torn out. The anterior talofibular ligament ATFL sprain is the most common, but the deltoid sprain is also prevalent in the many sports. What happened with the ATFL ligament? Anterior talofibular ligaments connect the talus to the tibia, and it's located on the outside of the ankle. The deltoid connect the medial malleolus to the tarsals, which consist of the navicular talus, cuboid and the calcaneum. Calcaneus, it is located on the inside of the ankle. As you can see in the pictures, inversion sprain, and this is the eversion sprain. Inversion sprain is also called the ATFL sprain, and eversion sprain is also called the deltoid sprain. In ATFL sprain, the ankle is inverted, causing the outside of your ankle, the ATFL, to stretch. In deltoid sprain, the ankle is everted, causing the inside of your ankle, the deltoid ligament, to stretch. So this is the image of the ligament torn or is the sprain. Now, how to assess the ankle sprain pain? When the ankle is straightened, pain on palpation on the injured ligament, swelling, discolorations, less range of motion. So this is the assessment of the ankle sprain. Now, how to treat the pain management? There are three different degree of sprain, from one being a mild ligament stretch that only required ice. For the initial sprain, over the 1 degree sprain, you just required the athlete required only rest. Third degree sprain of a ruptured ligament that would require surgery and sports medicine trainer to act on the mid sprain. So as we discussed earlier, the mnemonic is PRICE, P for prevent, rest during an ankle sprain to prevent the ligament from getting stressed torn even more, and help in repairing the torn ligament is very crucial. Minimal weight bearing, ice pack, and if possible ice bath would the best for the ankle sprain. The ice would assist with pain and swelling. No hit will be given to the sprained ankle. Next is compression. Athlete tape is the best treatment for a mild sprain, as it would help pull the ligament loose, so no more spraining is likely, and it would help repair the ligament. A tape job with padding and the tensor is the best. Next is elevations. Elevation help to prevent the torn ligament from weight bearing, making the injury worse. Now, what is the physiology of the swelling? In a more severe ankle sprain, intense inflammation is likely to cause lot of swelling, as blood flow and all the proteins and the cells would rush to the area of the ligament to try and create a natural split to prevent the ligament from stretching more, but also to begin setting the stages for the healing process. Next is taping. So how to tape in ATFL sprain and the deltoid sprain of the ankle joint? Athlete tape job with padding and tensors is the best for any ankle sprain. When taping, you are pulling away from the injury and the pain. ATFL tape job is, first one is the anchors. Second stage of the taping is 3-round syrup. Third stage, 2-round syrup of figure of 8. Start at lateral malleolus, outside of the ankle. Next is 2 rounds of heel locks. Start at the middle malleolus, inside the ankle joint. Repeat the anchor again. Clean up any empty spaces. Manitoba back door. Next is deltoid tape job. Again, anchor. Start with the anchors. 3 rounds stirrup. 2 rounds of figure of 8. Start at the middle malleolus, inside of the ankle. 2 rounds of heel lock. Start at the lateral malleolus. Repeat the anchor again. Clean up any empty space. Manitoba back door. Next is jammed finger. So mechanism of injury and the specific anatomy of the jammed finger. Jammed finger occur when a ball hit at the end of the finger phalanges and cause swelling at a certain joint in that finger. When a basketball player, for example, come into direct contact with your finger, it causes the tip of your finger to be compressed toward the hand, and that damage the bone and the ligament supporting the joint to be sprained out. The severity of jam fingers depends on how hard the ball or the any other force hit your finger. This can happen on any phalanges of your hand. Now, what is the how to assess and treat a jammed finger? Assessment of the finger is, there is a pain when the phalanges is palpated. Second is, not enough range of motion without pain for a specific phalange. Swelling and redness on the injured phalanges. Treating a jam finger. So the best treatment for treating a jam finger is the buddy taping. Buddy finger tape job would be the best treatment a trainers would be able to give. No weight applied on the fingers. For examples, even though not, you can carry the textbook also. If swelling, redness and pain persist, an x-ray would be suggested. Icing, and next is the apply splint until the finger healed would also help. What is the physiology behind the swelling? Swelling and discoloration would be present because of increased blood flow to the sprain. There would be the pain from the blood vessels, blood flows pressures on the nerves in the injured phalanges. Swelling would also protect the fingers from the further injury, and it also create the body's natural splint to protect further damage. Pain and the pain management, as we discussed earlier in the ankle sprain as well. Price, that would be the best mnemonic for the any sports injury. P for prevent. R is rest. Rest would be necessary to swelling to decrease and body to let itself heal before getting worse. Ice massage or an ice pack would be the best for the jammed finger or the sprained finger, as it would help with the finger and the swelling. For this specific injury, ice water immersions or the ice pack would be best. Compression would be best helpful to allow the ligament to heal. Also, the treatment for this injury would be buddy taping job to allow ligament to heal with the support of another finger. Elevation would be best for reducing the swelling. Now, how to tape the jam finger? The tapping method of the jam finger would be the buddy taping job. Bring the finger next to the injured. For example, my ring finger is injured. So, I would middle finger and the ring finger comes together and anchor taper twice at the level of two times in between the knuckles and the mid fingers and the mid fingers and at the level of nails. So, you can see in the image also. So this is the image of the buddy taping. Stress fracture. Mechanism of stress fracture is repetitive force placed upon a bone over time that are more than the bone can bear causes the stress fracture. When you repetitively overuse any muscle or the ligament, so this can cause the stress fracture. This is because the movement is so repetitive that the bones don't have time to heal and before they can heal properly. Another force is placed upon the injured bone and a stress fracture occurs. The repetitive force that causes a stress fracture is not great enough to cause a major fracture. In basketball, the stress fractures occur most often in second and the third metatarsals in the foot because this is where the majority of the force is placed in on your foot as it you push off when you walk and the run. Stress fracture, however, the also common in the calcaneus, talus and the navicular as well, is also enforced in those areas. Other factors increasing the risk of stress fractures including bone insufficiencies, conditions and disease that decrease bone strength and density. For example, osteoporosis. Next is poor conditioning, working the bone too much too soon, improper technique, change in surface and the improper equipment. So these all are the factors that cause the stress fracture of the foot or at the any joint. Assessing a stress fracture of the foot is swelling, redness and discoloration. These are the signs and symptoms. Inability to bear weight. Palpations near stress fracture is painful. Percussion test would be painful and would feel abnormal. X-ray at hospital would be best preferred to test for a stress fracture. treatment and taping of for a stress fracture is. Treatment for a stress fracture depend on the type and the severity of the fracture. So fracture would be, it would be green streak fracture, it would be compound fracture, and it would be spiral fracture. First treatment for the stress fracture is splint. Splint, you can use air splint, foam splint, etc. or a cast are the typical way to restrict further movement of the bone, which would cause pain to the nerves. Isolation of the joint above and below the injury will restrict complete movement of the bone. Second is padding with the towel, tensors, clothing, etc. make the splint more comfortable. Next is avoid scratching the skin around the cast or the splint, as this can cause the infections. Next is no weight bearing and movement is preferred. The uses of the crutch, knee walkers or the canes would also help to prevent the body from putting too much weight on the injured area. Ice can assist with superficial pain and swelling. If the stress fracture is extreme, surgery might be required to put the bone back in the place and make them stronger. The healing time for a stress fracture depends on the severity and the location of the injury. Taping is not required for a stress fracture. What is the physiology of the swelling or the inflammations? Swelling is expected as a stress fracture causes inflammation. Inflammation is caused by a loss of function in the area due to an increased size of the inflammations to get the necessary blood cells and proteins in the area to start acting on the injury. Swelling is also a result of the heat and redness from blood flow that comes through the vasodilation blood cells, plus pain from constant pressure on the nerves that cause the stress fracture, and thus the inflammation also results in the swelling. The pain and the pain management. Pain. For the pain management, you can go for the RICE treatment. Prevent, rest, rest on the injury, including no weight bearing until the fracture is completely healed, as stress fractures are caused by the repeated stress on that area. Ice is helpful for superficial pain and swelling in all stages of the fracture. Compression on the inflammation and the injury is necessary to prevent the inflammation from getting too big, but also because a tight area with little to no movement helps the injury heals better. Elevations during inflammation is necessary to prevent the fluid from gathering near the injury and the swelling up to big. Next one is the facial cuts and the nose injuries. The mechanism of injury and the specific anatomy of the facial cuts and the nose injuries, with elbow and the arms roaming uncontrollably during the basketball. Facial cuts and nose injuries ranging from the nose bleeds to nose fractures are common. Some nose injuries are also able to damage the nasal septum that divide into two passages. A nose injury is caused by a direct hit to the nose by someone or something. Facial cuts are generally caused by small sharp objects scraping the face as players follow or defend the ball, and by the constant friction caused throughout rubbing. So this is the images of the facial cuts and the nose bleeding and nose injuries. Assessing the facial cuts and the nose injuries. So how to assess the facial cuts and the nose? Facial cuts usually visible to the eye and needs instant treatment to prevent further infections. However, things are like bruises, burns and the blisters on the face cause pain and should be looked upon. As for the nose injuries, some symptoms include pain on the nose, bleeding, swelling and discolorations, deformity of the nose, difficulty in the breathing. Treating the facial cuts and the nose injuries. Facial cuts, clean, it should be cleaned, facial cuts should be cleaned and covered, and for the protection it should be covered. Clean the cut using hydrogen peroxide, cinder salts and alcohol pads, etc. For cleaning, you can use this hydrogen peroxide as well as this cinder salts and alcohol pads. Covering using bands, aids, gauze piece, cover all, etc. Burn, blister or the bruises should also be covered by the second skin to prevent the further damage. Now in nose injury, SMED trainers can assist with nose bleeds by putting a tampon or the gauze up to the nose. If the nose is just bruised, with the help of the eyes, it can heal in some days. SMED trainers, SMED trainers can assist with fractured nose by stabilizing it with padding and sending the players to the hospital for an X-ray. If the nose is fractured, determined through an X-ray and the extreme pain, surgery would be required. Now, what is the physiology and the taping? Swelling is generally present for the facial cuts. However, the red blood cells with platelets do rush to the site of the cut to prevent excessive bleeding. But with a fractured nose with intense swelling, inflammation would be present to act as a natural splint from further damaging the nose. Tapping is not required for facial cuts or the nose injury. Now, next is pain and the pain management. Rest is only required for nose injuries. If the nose is bleeding too much, doing too many activities involving jumping and running, which players air rushes out of your nose, would cause more blood to come out faster. Also, the rest would be the best for nose fracture to prevent the further damage. Ice pack would be best for the nose bleed and especially nose fracture to assist with pain and swelling. Deep thigh bruising. Mechanism of injury and specific anatomy of the deep thigh bruising. Deep thigh bruising, also commonly known as pulled muscle, happen in the quadriceps muscle. The quadriceps is the front of the thigh muscle. It is when a direct hit the thigh result in a tear or a stretch in the large medial muscles or tendons in the thigh. This can happen by being in constant activity that includes jumping or sprinting, which in the basketball appears a lot. The injury takes place on the following muscles: the rectus femoris, vastus lateralis, vastus medialis and the vastus intermedius muscle. These muscles are attached to the femur bone, so when a direct blow is taken on the basketball player thigh, the muscle will be rushed against the bone. Now, how to assist deep thigh bruising? Start by palpating the top of your thigh muscle all the way to the bottom, making the athlete go into a flexion and extension position to test for range of motion. Looking for discoloration or any swelling, try weight bearing by making them walk or stand on the injured area. So these all are the basic point for assessing the deep bruising thigh muscle. The athlete will need to immediately stop doing physical activity, put an ice pack wrapped in cloth on the area every 3 to 4 hours for up to 20 minutes for 3 to 4 days or until pain and swelling is gone. The athlete can also give themselves ice massage. They will need to get a styrofoam cup full of frozen water and rub the ice over the area like a massage for 10 to 15 minutes. They will also need to keep the thigh elevated by placing the pillow when patient in supine lying or when the athlete in the supine lying. The athlete will need to wear an elastic to wear around their thigh for the compression after their thigh has recovered days after. A mild bruising can also take a few weeks to heal, but a severe bruising can take up to 6 weeks or longer. Inflammation will be expected as it will swell to create a natural splint for further damaging. Next is taping. So taping is wrapped thigh from just below the groin to just above the knee. You can use kinesio tape or athlete tape with pro wrap. Next is chin splint, medial tibial stress syndrome. Shin splint, the mechanism of shin splint is, shin splint happen when the muscle near your tibia bone gets swollen and irritated from overuse or stress fractures, which are tiny breaks in the lower leg bone. Another cause of the shin splint can cause overpronation or lastly poor lumbar spine functions. Basketball player can get this by changing their workout intensity or changing the surface the player usually run out. the direction which can create this injury would be the superior motion since it is coming from the ground. The muscles that get swollen and bring the athlete pain are the tibialis anterior muscle and the soleus and the extensor digitorum longus. These muscles are attached to the tibia, which is the shin bone. The pain usually comes from the anterior aspect of the shin or the medial part of the lower leg, which would be the pain in the inside the shin bone. So this image you can see as the tibialis anterior muscles and from the medial side and the lateral side. How to assess and treat the shin pain? Assessment: palpate down the shin bone front and back. Weight bearer ask them to stand. Now what is the treatment of the shin splint? Tell the basketball player to stop running completely or decrease their training until they have fully healed. But they should do low impact sports like swimming and cycling. Ice is the key for treating this injury. It reduces the inflammation of the injury. With no exceptions, massage the area with water that has been frozen, a styrofoam cup, for 10 minutes up to 4 times a day for 2 weeks. This will make the pain and the swelling mild or no longer existent. Now, how the physiology and the pain management? Swelling is expected due to vasodilations and a stage of 4 healing. For this injury, basketball player want is use cold treatment as it will calm down swelling and pain. They should use ice, either applied directly with a wrapped ice pack or massage it with an ice cup. Taping would be suggested. Athlete will just tape their shin with the S tape by wrapping it from knee to ankle, or they wear a sleeve as it may be more comfortable because it compresses the muscle and permit less muscle movement. Next is groin strain. The mechanism of injury is a groin strain happens when there is too much stretch on the muscle in the groin and the thigh. When these muscles are tended too forcefully or suddenly, the muscles get overstretched or torn. Direction and forces that would cause this injury would be sudden jumping or changing directions, which is very common on the act of basketball. Groin strain are common for athlete that run a lot. Sudden pain will be felt either in the belly or the muscles or higher where the tendon attached to the pelvis bone. The muscle that is usually pulled or torn out is adductor longus, which is the part of the short adductor family. The muscle is attached to the pelvis bone and the femur. This muscle help movement in the hip and help pull the legs together. Now how to assess, treat and the pain management? Palpate right below the groin to feel if any deformities are present. Weight bear to see the type of degree and the stretch. As I said earlier, price treatment would be best treatment for any athlete for any injury. Rest is important because it will give time for the injury to heal. Don't do full impact injuries. Ice pack apply to the area for 20 minutes for 3 to 4 days to minimize the swelling and the pain. Compression, use an elastic wrap or athlete bandage to apply pressure and stop swelling. Elevation, keep leg elevated by placing it on pillow. The basketball player can do this by laying down. What is the physiology and the taping? Inflammations from RBCs, WBCs and protein will make the muscles swell and have a lot of blood flow to the area, increasing swelling and setting a stage from healing while creating a natural splint. To tape a groin strain, it be to use kinesio tape or spider technique. Apply as directed from the medial upper thigh. Next is hamstring strain. So mechanism of injury of hamstring strain is, hamstrings is the back muscle of your thigh. Hamstring allow you to bend your leg at the knee joint. Hamstring strains happen when one of the muscle is thigh get overloaded. This can happen when you don't warm up before the exercising, sudden jumping or stopping or any staring at a fast rate. In the hamstring, there are four muscles, that is semitendinosus, semimembranosus, bicep femoris and the soleus. All these muscles are attached to the femur and the tibia bone. So assessment of the hamstring strain is, palpate the back of your thigh muscle from top to bottom. Test for range of motion by asking them to flexion of the knee joint and the extension of the knee joint. Check the discoloration of that area. Now next is treatment and pain management. Use the RICE method as it is best for this injury. Rest, avoid weight bearing, use a crutch if necessary. Rest by stopping full impact sports until fully healed. Ice your leg by doing 20 to 30 minutes of your using an ice pack directly on the area for 3 days or until pain and swelling is gone. Compressions, use an elastic bandage to compress swelling. Elevation, that is use pillow under the injured leg to elevate when lying down. What is the physiology and the taping? Inflammation will be present and there will be swelling and pain since the tightening of the muscles leads to the increased blood flow. Using kinesio taping is the best for the hamstring strain. Apply tape down back of upper thigh all the way down, then add another tape band horizontally at the middle of your thigh. It looks like this. Next one is, the last one is the lumbar strain. The mechanism of the injury is and the specific anatomy behind the lumbar strain. Lumbar strain is an injury that is caused by stretching the ligaments, tendons or the muscles of the lower back. Improper use, trauma or overuse can always be a cause of lumbar strain. The muscles that can get injured are the erector spinae muscles, the latissimus dorsi muscles. These muscles are attached to the ribs and the spinal vertebrae. Assessment and inflammation of the lumbar strain. Palpate the lower back. Test the range of motion by asking them to do the lumbar ROMs. That is forward bending, backward bending, lateral flexions. Inflammation will be present with swelling and pain with discoloration due to tightening of the muscles. Now what is the treatment, pain and the taping? Use of cold is the best for trolling this injury as ice will minimize blood flow and swelling. It is also good for a treatment after the swelling has been passed away. The athlete should apply ice on their lower back for 20 to 30 minutes every 3 hours for 2 to 3 days. Apply heat after 2 to 3 days of icing or after the swelling has been passed away. Take painkillers if the pain is unbearable, and you can visit as well as the physicians. No taping necessary, but athlete should use a lumbar braces. So this is all about basketball injury. Thank you.